The first scheduling policy is a very simple one, first come, first served. And what this is saying is that you look at the order of arrival of threads into the scheduling queue of the scheduler and pick the one that is the earliest to become runnable again. And that's the one that you're going to schedule. So what this is saying is, well, basically, we will give importance to fairness for threads as opposed to affinity. So it is ignoring affinity altogether and simply saying, let's just be fair. We'll pick the thread that became runnable at the earliest. That's the one that we're going to pick as the next one to run on the processor. That's first come, first served. The second scheduling policy is called fixed processor, or in other words, for every thread, when I schedule the thread the first time, I'm going to pick a particular processor. And I'm always going to stick to that. So the processor on which TI will run, it'll always be a particular fixed processor. And the way we choose the initial processor on which to schedule TI may depend on the load balance, making sure that all the processors in the multiprocessor are equally stressed in terms of using the resources for running the available threads that are there in the system. And that's how I pick a particular processor. But for the life of this thread, the processor on which TI is going to run is always fixed. So that's the fixed processor scheduling. The third scheduling policy is what is called a last processor scheduling policy. The idea here is the processor is going to pick among the set of threads that are available to be run at any point of time. It is going to pick a thread that used to run on it. Or in other words, if TI, the last time it had any cycles from the system, was in a particular processor, then when this processor is coming around looking for work, it'll see, oh, TI is there. It used to run on me. I'm going to pick that guy to run on me again. And as you can imagine, this is giving preference to the fact that there could be affinity for TI to this processor because it used to run on this. So that is what is called last processor scheduling. And of course, when a processor is looking for work and it looks at the run queue, does not find any thread that used to run on it, then of course it has to pick some thread, right? So the inclination is to pick the thread that had run on this processor before, the last, and that's the one that I want to schedule on PLAST. But if such a thread is not available, then you're going to pick something else. So the idea behind this is that you want to make sure that if this processor is going to pick a thread to run on it, the likelihood of this thread finding its memory contents in this processor is high. That's what we're trying to shoot for in this last processor. The next couple of scheduling policies I'm going to tell you about, it requires more sophistication in terms of the information that the scheduler needs to keep on behalf of every thread in order to make its scheduling decision. The next scheduling policy is what is called minimum intervening scheduling policy, MI for short. And in MI, what we're going to do is the following. We're going to keep for every thread its affinity with respect to a particular processor and pick the processor for running this thread in which this thread has the highest affinity.